Hello everyone. So here we are with another video on Excel tasks that we can do in Power Query. We'd like to do them in Power Query. These are easy enough to do in Excel, but we just want to do it in Power Query in line with all the other transformations that we've been learning so far. Okay, so the first task that we want, by the way, these tasks that are listed here are more for text type columns. For instance, we have a one column data in here with a course name, and they are all in text format. So we want to find the length, how we want to find it. We want to trim them, change them to uppercase, lowercase, and capitalize each word. Okay, so just looking very quickly, if you look at the second and third row, they're exactly the same health and health slash grade 7. But the third one, the third row, has some leading white space. Okay, so there's that leading white space, although the background is black, but there's some space before the letter H, right? In fact, if we find the length of each one of these, so let's do equals len. So that goes for the length. And open parentheses, let's find the cell of the text that we want to find the length of. Close parentheses. I am on table format. That's why everything else is populated. Okay, so let's look at this first. Health grade 7. It says it has 14 characters, but the other one has 17, and that three other characters is because of that leading white space in front of the letter H. Similarly with algebra 1, they're both algebra 1 and they look like they line up, but yet they have different length, and that's because if you click on this one, you have that trailing space after the capital Roman numeral one? Yeah. So you have that leading trailing space. So the spaces after the word is called trailing, and the spaces before the word is called leading. And we want to get rid of that. That's part of our cleaning, and that's how we do the trimming. Okay, so let's get on our data. I'm going to remove the column that has the length by just backtracking this. Let's load our data. Go to data on top in your ribbon. Choose data slash range to capture the data set. Okay, so the first task at hand is find the length. So therefore, I'm going to duplicate this row. Okay, so I'm going to do right click and then duplicate row. And this second one is the one that I want to use for text length. I'm going to just name that text length. Okay, so I'm going to use this to find the length of each text here, which is a copy of that one, or this is a copy of this one. Okay, by doing right click and then go to transform, and you will see all these transformations that you can do for text related columns. So the first one we want is to do the length. And so true enough, this is the length of each one of these text on the first column. Row number 2, number 3, even though they're exactly the same words, but they don't have the same length. Same thing with 4 and 5. And we'll try to fix that. So this is the original text length. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this again. And the reason I want to copy is this is the one that I want to trim. So I'm going to name this one trimmed. From text. Obviously, I'm doing all this repetitive work because I want to illustrate what's happening to each one, right? Okay, so from here, I'm going to do a right click, go to transform, and then go trim. And as you can see, that health got flushed to the left. And we'll see. Okay, so we will try to find, I'm going to duplicate this one now. And I want to find the length of this and see if they all are the same. Okay, so I'm going to go right click. And then transform, and then length. So as you can see, so this is the trim text, this is the original text, and yet on the trim text, the health slash grade 7 have the same length now, and algebra 1 have the same length. This is 10 and 12 and 10 on the original one, so apparently both of them have trailing spaces, but the original length of the word is just 9 characters, okay? All right, so now that we have that, I'm going to remove that. Now that we have learned how to do the length and the trimming, I'm just going to remove all these steps. I just want to keep the original one. So we can move on to our next. Actually, I'm gonna keep that duplicated one, okay? So now the next one is to change or to transform them to uppercase. So uppercase, that means every single letter here will be converted into an uppercase format of letter. So we can right click, go to transform, and go click uppercase. And true enough, it's in there. Everything is in capitalized format. Okay, I'm gonna remove this step again. I'm gonna use this same column to do the lowercase, transform, do a lowercase, and everything is in lowercase. So all of these transformations sometimes we use to compare it with another column so that you can equate them or compare them with something. So these are just, again, different ways of transforming your text. Okay, so I'm going to delete this, and our last task is to capitalize each word, and it's pretty much everything is capitalized here except for the first row. Language arts, the L and the A should be capitalized, and so we'll do that. So we'll do right-click again, transform, and then capitalize each word. Okay, so now we have that. Let's trim this so that it's all cleaned up. Okay, so transform and trim. Okay, and so now we're good, and we want to load this. So I'm going to go close and load under home, close and load to. Okay, so this is 92,000 lines, so that's why it's taking a little bit of time to process it. Okay, so now we have table, click OK, and it should create a new tab called table 13 in this case, and this is your new table. All right, so see you on our next set of video on how to transform some data in Power Query, and see you then.